This thing. Testing 1, 2, 3. Testing 1, 2, 3. This will be a recording of the regular meeting, the Board of Directors, 5th District, GSMA, January the 5th, 1970.
Would the Board of Directors of the 5th District, GSMA, please come to order? Merry Christmas.
God and Father, we are grateful for your blessings during the past year. We ask your continued blessings during the coming year and during the coming 1970. We ask your blessing on each one of us personally, our families, and our profession. Aid us in the work of this great profession of ours. We ask these things in Christ's name. Amen.
Thank you.
Praise
the Lord.
This is Lot.
Yeah.
This is Armstrong.
Yeah.
This is Fitzpatrick.
Yeah.
Miss Crawford.
Yeah.
Sister Christie.
Yeah.
Miss Wells.
Yeah.
And Miss Stanley.
Yeah.
This is Atkins.
Yeah.
This is
Quorum.
A quorum has been established. Action on the minutes is circulated for November 10th. Have you all read the minutes? Would you like to make a motion there?
I heard the
minutes be approved as circulated.
Second.
A motion has been made that the minutes be approved for November 10th. All in favor? Opposed? Are there any additions or corrections to these minutes?
It's too late, man.
Too late.
They've
already been
approved.
You're absolutely right. Let's change it.
No, it's never too late to actually amend the minutes.
Right.
Put it that way. Why?
There are some communications. Getting ready to do some work. We have Christmas cards. And Ms. Disfield. This is new.
Now, there's a note on that.
Yeah.
You got to read the note.
Okay. Oh.
Oh.
Okay. From Mrs. Lewis. Thank you so much for the lovely arrangement. I wish all of you could see. You're too nice to the employee, but I love it. She got a real pretty floral arrangement.
Mm-hmm. It's all sealed up and put up so I can get it out of it. Just beautiful.
From Miss Crawford, the Department of Nursing at Grady Memorial. Mrs. Price, St. Joseph's Infirmary, Sisters of Mercy, and Margaret Parker. We also got a very, very lovely thank you note from Mrs. Fitzpatrick for the dinner, which we deeply appreciated. We have a note from Mrs. Stanley thanking us for our remembrance of her family, her sister, and from Mr. Robert Fleming Whitaker, expression of sympathy. The report of the secretary, still there, do you have a report?
No.
The treasurer?
$4,071.94. And the receipts for the month of November. checks out at the time to report were $527.84, and this total would agree with the bank statement of $3,298.50. And on deposit at Atlantic Federal Savings and Loan Association, we have $1,121.88.
Report of Executive Secretary.
I sent you a report of the membership with the minutes before Christmas. That report is what was actually paid, and you may question the little difference there. I've forgotten whether it's $1.33. On the new computer, the installments are $3.35 instead of $3.33, so that's why we had to show that little difference there. Now, this morning came in your new list of our membership as of November, and this includes some who have joined since the October state convention and have paid dues for 1970, but it excludes those who did not continue. They still have some on there who have installments due within 60 days, but I will give you the total. I had no way of knowing from the new report what sections they were in, but this one gives it as of November 1969, EATC section 119, general duty 203, private duty 179, NSA 202, occupational health 32, 6 in office, which we do not have in Georgia, 199 public health, that's an all-time high for them. I think about 115 to 120 has been the highest previously. And in the psychiatric, which we do not have, there were 6 in that one. In the school nurses, which should be in public health, were 9. 15 head nurses should be in the NSA section. And 1 operating room, we have none in Georgia. And also there were 9 who gave no sections, which gave the current total of 980. And that's the total as explained to you on November. They say they have 2 who have from 1 to 60 days unpaid dues and 61 to 150 days who are delinquent 20. So it does make a difference in the numbers now. And while I'm reporting to you, the books are up to date. We're just waiting on the statement, which came in today at noon. And as soon as I can get them together, we will be ready for the auditor. And our total receipts this year, I don't think I've given this to Sister, because it isn't completed yet. This is a tentative, was $17,215.66. And we transferred from savings $500. And then we transferred from the registry fund $193.93, making our total of $18,388.92. We had balance last year $482.33, and our disbursements were $15,186.07. Now, we've already received $313.30 for dues for next year, which will be on the December. And it will agree, and does agree with our clearing the bank was 2007-76, which agreed with the bank statement there. This was done before I left because I didn't expect any receipts, but I couldn't complete it until the 1st. And we have, I think one thing I want to tell you, is one of our big printing deals, in Casey's question, we had to get the dues notices printed last January because they were lost in the mail. We then again had to get our little folder revised because we went on a new procedure. There was some question about us in the punch card, but every day I am more convinced that $393 we paid for these will be more than worth it. For instance, today, now I had cleared 23 new ones that came in after the state meeting, and today alone, had she not sent me back this card, this one had been distributed by someone else because I'm not giving out the self-mailer. I'm keeping it myself until I get this card, filling it in, and mailing it to the person with directive. The date of graduation has to be completed on that, and let her mail it. I mean, if it's a self-mailer, she should mail it, and it approved by the district. Well, this one came in today, and it's approved by Miss Henley, and as much as we admire Miss Henley and all, if these are given out at random and we had no way of keeping any control over it, or knowing, or having one go through one official channel, or having your method. Now, from this card at your next meeting, we will have the list of the 23 plus any others. And if you have your meeting on the 15th, we will have the list ready for them, which will be taken from the card. Otherwise, we'd have nothing, because this would go to New York. So all I can say is it's been a real busy year. We start off this year, we need members, and I think all of us should work on it. Other than that, everything's up to date except to clean up a little bit and get the auditor's report to him. We hope our auditor will go ahead and do us early. That's all I have to say.
Thank you, Karen. Reports from standing committees, bylaws, Mrs. Armstrong.
We have not met. I do have the public health bylaws, the formal bylaws committee has. But I didn't call a meeting because I believe Ms. Atkins said one other section was coming forth with theirs, and I thought maybe we could do them both at the same time. So I haven't done anything about bylaws.
I'm not sure that EACC section has done anything about them since their last meeting. They really. Ethical, legal, and professional standards as well.
We are planning a program to be with the NSA section on January 3rd.
Take that back.
Do you know what your program will be? Finance, Mrs. Monk is not here. Mrs. Rittenhouse, legislation is not here. Mrs. Lott, membership.
Membership committee has had one meeting. Not all members were present. I have the wrong book to tell you how many were present. Another meeting is planned on the 15th. I hope the membership committee is going to be quite active. We have divided up professional interest groups and assigned them to members of the committee. So hopefully the committee will be active and will do everything they can to increase the membership that's coming in.
Would you also promote active membership? See if we can get some people to some meetings.
Sure we will. We're going to work on it.
Nominations, Mrs. Jacobs is not here. Emergency Health and National Defense, Ms. Rosenau is not here. Programs, Ms. Fox.
We haven't had a meeting yet to work on the May meeting. We do have Mr. Mercer from the Merrill Lynch, Pierce, Fenner, and Smith coming to the meeting on Thursday, and I hope there's a good group there to listen to him. He talks about investments, and we thought that might attract. It'll be a brief. We've asked him not to talk more than 20 minutes, but to entertain a few questions. So that'll be brief part of the regular business meeting, and the next program meeting will be the May meeting, and we'll plan probably a committee meeting in February and plan for that meeting.
I think they ought to know you've had many, many compliments on your anniversary dinner, golden anniversary. I saw Mr. Gilbert Macklemore a few minutes ago. He told us how sorry that he couldn't be there, that he had heard what a nice meeting.
He
and
had,
we did have Miss Vanderbrader recorded.
Yeah.
On
good. We had a nice, informal, kind of a fun evening, I thought. Heard some interesting things about how it was back there.
Yeah.
see it in the future, which I thought was a real interesting contrast in many ways. That young man.
We sent that picture to AJN. I don't know whether we'll get anything from it. No, we had some made, and the pictures that we got of the individuals did not flatter. I hadn't had time to send them out. I mean, the little ones looked fine, but then he cut them up. Instead of having the group pictures and all, just singled out individuals, have a real good one with you and Mr. Hamilton. And some of the others did not do as much justice as it would have been in a smaller group in there. But we did send it to AJN, see what we can get.
Public relations and liaison, Mrs. Simmons is out here.
She did meet in December, and they did get oriented and start making plans, and as soon as you get underway with your May program, they've already assigned different ones for radio and television news coverage.
Oh, good.
So they'll be glad to work with you.
Could I interrupt, Bill? You have a copy of the minutes, do you not, about our meeting of the...
I have it, but I don't have it here.
Well, there was a request in there from the committee that this board assign a person to each one of those study groups that Ms. Gates has had. And they've been liking it, you know, here, instead of bringing my books, I've got Medicare instead of this. <and like.
laughs> I don't have yours with me because it's in the file.
Yeah, well, that it was in there, though, for the board to assign one young nurse in the section where Mrs. Gates' group meets. If you all read the minutes, you remember that was a request. So I haven't got it with me, and I guess we couldn't do it unless we had the...
Well, could you make some suggestions of people you think would be appropriate and leave it up to the membership committee to make this sign? We'll meet on January 15th.
Did you stay that long?
No, that's why what would be the purpose of...
Well, there are five different neighborhood groups that Ms. Gates has of New Creek.
Mm-hmm.
And she wants to get them into here tonight. She thinks they would be excellent potential numbers. They're not all numbers. So her feeling was that if the parent organization, which would be us, would appoint one person to be the liaison between the district and the study clubs, that they could encourage membership. And so the request came from the membership committee that this board appoint a person. And that was in the minutes of our meeting.
No, I think it's part of your duties, what I'm thinking about. Because you're a membership.
You mean we have to do it?
That you have to have that would be part of your duties to
do that.
To supply that person, even one of your committee. Even.
Well, okay, we're going to have a meeting on the 15th, so maybe we'll have to.
See, this would seem to be the best body to get these people from, because they're already involved in membership.
Well, her feeling was that she hated to do the refreshment and then turn around, you know, and ask them to join.
Well, I can see her. I mean, I've been in the same position with an AP, you see.
Yeah.
And, you see, develop methods.
So I guess what we could do is just...
And assist in programs to recruit inactive nurses into nursing. And then up here, you see, develop plans for retaining and increasing membership. All of this is your, I thought, you know, I don't
discuss that further on the 15th.
I think that is their duty, though.
Your committee, too, Merle, is set up so that you can include other members in it.
Subcommittee.
Somebody ourselves. They wanted somebody young and alert who just meet with them frequently. We're all too old. Okay.
Thank you. If it's within the bylaws, you can do it.
Okay.
very helpful, Merle. As a matter of fact, reports of special committees, Mrs. Lott, your health commission on area-wide plan.
We've had one meeting in November. There is to be another meeting in the last of this month to elect the officers. I think this committee, I mean this board would be interested to know that the application for funding was turned down for the health comprehensive plan. Now, it was turned down on a technicality, and those technicalities have been righted, and the request for funding has been resubmitted. The only thing that's happened is a 3-month delay in getting underway, but everybody is quite encouraged that this will be a temporary thing, and the meeting is to be held for nomination of officers. Now, I can submit, after the chairman are elected for the committee, I can submit names for committee members from our group. They would not necessarily have to be representing an agency on the staff. For instance, since I'm the representative, it can be anybody else. They can enlarge the committee. But that meeting will not be until January, and after the committee chairman has been chosen, Dr. Levine tells me that that is when we will submit names for the different committees. And after this happens, if funding takes place, I will call you if you would like to get some suggestions, or the board could give me the names at the present time to submit for the various committees. One on home health, one on mental health, one on, the environment, all of these, just the regular standing committees they've had. And I had it in my head.
I'm sure you did. Does anybody have any suggestions for the Do you know there's one on, could you tell us the names of them again?
Well, I would have to go and get Ms. Jones to tell me. There's one on maternal and child health, one on family plan, one on mental health, one on pollution of environment, one on juvenile court, juvenile problems. It's things like this, one on hospitals. So I think that any one of the committees, with the exception of
beginning, though, to think whether we need a representative on this committee or not, but we'll talk about that later. There is another representative that I have appointed. What's her name? Oh, Helen Pemberton is the special representative to a committee which is evaluating the comprehensive healthcare center, Southside. And she has been meeting with these people to evaluate nursing service as it is being given out there. Her last report was the day before Christmas, and it has turned into a political football. So we will wait on that and see what happens. It seems that the only reason they are meeting is because it was built into the bylaws that they should meet. And it's just a token thing. And when they sat down to really get down to evaluating the health care services that were being given, that they were told they weren't supposed to do this. So right now they're going around in circles trying to find out exactly how to best attack this. So we're at a standstill there. Reports the sections, Mrs. Fitzpatrick. I heard a lot of nice things about that.
And well, this told me we are planning some more business than our next
Mrs. Burns isn't here. Mrs. Smith isn't here. They had, I think, at least 45 or 50 at that meeting. They invited the eight. Unfortunately, the date, as you know, corresponded with the date of our friendship dinner. And commitments were made that neither one of us could change, invitations and so forth. But I think they had about 45 or 50 there and helped encourage and just said it was a very nice meeting.
Carolyn, how do I, you know, we changed and went into that section meeting, but I don't get any notices that you
Well,
because they're called meetings, aren't they? They don't have it scheduled.
They're called. Everybody that I had in the right section gets meetings now. I don't know what section you're listed in.
Well, I should be in ESC.
It may be that you're in public health. I don't know.
But I changed it on the new registration.
You're not getting that.
Well, we haven't checked the new 1970 list.
That's it.
But you will be checked. Yeah. That's the very next thing will be done next week. But as a rule, we don't even check them until the end of the time because most of the time they notify us that they're changing.
Well,
the ANA, you know, has been sending us little cards, and they went on a new computer in September. And what they did, they gave us things like this. It's going to take me a solid week to go through it and find those changes.
Well,
because
that occurs, then maybe all I need to do is call Ms. Burns.
Is to wade through here, and that's what... As soon as the books go to the auditors, that everyone we will have will be changed. It's going to be a problem until we learn how to interpret it. That I don't know whether they're going to send us a big one like this every time or directly on each one, and have you got to wait in there and see whether or not there are any changes or not. We're just playing along until we find out.
That's not
but
as bad as the bank. I've been trying for 6 months to get my address changed.
Each time.
I don't have but one person on the spinel that hadn't been changed. When they notify me, then I do it. But and I have some method of doing it. But when it comes in from ANA, first it comes in cards, and we've kept up with the cards. We've done that, but they changed over in September, and they were late. Then we got two little reports in December. But, of course, with all of our activities, December, there was absolutely no chance of going ahead and making the changes. We did get back about 10 envelopes from our mailing of your calendar, which is less than any time I can recall. You remember on the voting how many came back, and 10 was a minor one. But if I can possibly know about it, and they let me know, you know, I go ahead and see that to get the notices, because that's, I think
I feel like that's very important.
Mr. Peacock, Public Health, not here.
I do know that they had their Christmas meeting. They had a nice tea, wasn't it, Merle, over at the town?
Unfinished business. We did agree to allow me to nominate some people to be on an ad hoc committee for the most involved nurse and the Mary Mahoney Award. And the chairman of this committee was Mrs. Ruth Campbell, and the committee members were Loretta Roberts, Helen Belcher, Mrs. Levette, Mary Woody, and Carolyn Atkins. Can you report?
I didn't know I wasn't invited. I didn't hear about it. I can tell you that we did have a report of two, and the letter was sent before I left. We weren't clear whether Ms. Campbell was going to report to the state on that, so rather than take any chances, I called over and also called the day before I left. They said Ms. Overton was too busy to talk to me, but anyhow, I left on the 20th, and this was on the 19th. So she was with Ms. Cates and involved and all, so that's all I could do. So I enclosed the two nominees submitted by the 5th District on GSNA for the Fee Involved Nurse Search, and the ad hoc committee selected Mrs. Mary E. Cates and Ms. Nancy C. Root for consideration for this national honor. And of course, we wished them a happy new year and so forth. In today's mail, which was stacked up about this high, we did have one more nominee, Catherine Pope, and I delayed it till in the morning in the event that anybody else here had people they'd like to add to it. So I'll write one more letter about it. I did not know who the Mary Mahoney nominee was. There's no official report in it. All I got was some nomination blanks. So I took a photostatic copy of the nominations as they were sent to us so we'd have one on file. And there was no report or any suggestion as to whether or not it had been done directly to the state. But I didn't know that I was on the committee. They did call me over the telephone and ask me some of the qualifications and some of the activities of it, so maybe they considered that to my part.
You had a job you didn't know you had.
Yeah.
I'll talk to Ruth and see if I get an official report from her. Because I don't know who she sent in for Mary Mahoney Award either. Is there any other unfinished business?
We're holding it for her right here. Let her announce. I saw her put that on the agenda this morning. I didn't know whether she'd heard from the drug company and the other people there, so we delayed it.
I closed the convention account by writing a check to this district GSNA for $1,648.95. And I'm through.
That committee did a wonderful job, and
yeah,
I think
sure
this board
did.
Is certainly grateful.
They deserve a vote.
There
thanks.
Will be an official breakdown, you know, financial report, but I don't have it real interest. I mean, I made it come out even too.
As the minutes stated in the last report, that it would be first they discussed about discussing at this particular meeting, and the way it's entered in our minutes that we go ahead and set up a separate fund in the savings at Atlanta Federal. Is that the intent?
interpretation in what this group wants. Do you want it listed as a convention fund or just a savings fund, 50-50? Separate from our regular savings fund, I mean, is there any feeling on that?
As I remember, the conversation about this was that this was what we were supposed to do with it until at another time we decide what we will do with it. Well, we were so late getting some of the funds in that I didn't get the money to Carolyn to put in savings after this. And somebody mentioned this was conversation, not action, I think, that you might want to do something about in January if people had an idea.
There is a motion on the minutes about it, and from the motion and the interpretation would be that it would be go ahead and set up in a separate fund in the Atlanta Federal Savings. Is that right, Miss?
Yes.
You aren't?
Yeah.
Yeah.
No, I was just remembering it was in there because there was some discussion about putting it on the building.
Separate savings account at Atlanta Federal. The paragraph before that mentions what Merle was talking about in the minutes. What's your pleasure?
Since that's already been voted on there and approved
voted.
On there,
yeah.
Wouldn't it be well if you read it and also have it on the recorder here?
It was moved and seconded that remaining monies from 1969 annual meeting be placed in a separate savings account at Atlanta Federal Savings Association. Motion was carried.
We have no emergency need of these funds to be assisted.
Not right now. Because the what we're going to have as far as membership, you know, to function each year is kind of tight. Membership right now, and the membership that it wasn't going to get no tight enough.
That's right. We probably in June and July evaluating what our status is.
Well, for one, I would be very money being used for operating. I think that an organization should be supported by its dues, if you can call it that. And this money was from all over the state and not this district. So I would like to go back to a paragraph before the motion which states Goldbricks the lowest in contribution from the 5th District to GSNA Building Fund. Some discussion is how to get monies for this fund. Some discussion is how to use the remaining monies from the state meeting. And this is the point I think Merle was bringing up, that there was quite a bit of discussion about this, and what we did, what was prompted the motion was a temporary disposition of the money to go into savings until such time that we decided how to use this. And I think somewhat of a stalemate, and this Merle got us, I believe Merle made the motion, got us out of this dilemma last time by this motion. I think we're still at the same point as far as I'm concerned, and I
being obstinate about it, because I feel strongly that an organization should be supported by its dues. And I don't believe this is dues.
And you would really like to make, to give it to the building fund, is that right?
Yes, we voted, you know, at convention last year, your boy, $10 a member, and we have not made this money in any way. It didn't say we assessed them $10, it said we pledged $10 per member. And however it was made, we haven't followed through. This might be a little step toward it.
I wonder if something might be done in the district meeting to encourage membership to go ahead and contribute the $10 for the GSMA headquarters building fund. Because I noticed that we were the very lowest on the total poll at the annual meeting.
You might look at it this way too, Ms. Armstrong, that if you give all this money that your committee works sort of hard to get, that's relieving the individuals who should have contributed the $10. I think you have a very worthy point there. Once you give it to the state, since the money did come from all over the state. I think that we should be trying to get the individual members to give their part. And $10 isn't so much.
It isn't much, but Callum can say how many times we approached the membership in writing last year, ever since the convention, didn't we, Callum?
Oh, we printed 4,000 little gold bricks and so forth, and we've been after it all together.
And what did we get, 300?
Many of them were not in agreement for it. Said they would not plan on building right now. They didn't feel it was the time to build. I mean, I'm giving you the feeling of the members.
Well, actually, the state has decided not to build at this time because of terrific increase in interest and other reasons. But there still is a need, desperate need, in the state for headquarters.
At the annual meeting, they were to look into the moving of the state headquarters to a more desirable area, and I have not been here and haven't heard anything further. I wonder if this plan went to the state board meeting, knows if they're making any progress. I mean, this is a matter of
I haven't heard anything.
Well, the headquarters committee has not met because I've been very interested in it and happened to work with a girl who's on the committee, and she says they have not met.
Since it's not emergency, may I make this suggestion on that? As I understand it, our finance committee is the committee that's responsible for the monies, any monies that come into the district. Or we go ahead and deposit and forget about it until we see what programs in the state or the district or see whether either one of us are going to survive. Personally, I would not want to use one dime for our fifth district headquarters. If we can get enough membership dues to support us, we've been promised that they'd support us until we got on our feet, and I wouldn't conscientiously use one dime of that. But for convention, yes, because that's why we're so broke now, is because this district has had to send more delegates to the national conventions, you know, previously when the alternates would be from Atlanta and dug into our funds and so forth. And I certainly would want us to do our part toward the building fund. But it would seem to me that our finance committee is delegated the responsibilities for the monies with the approval of the board and the proper authority. Do we have to do it right now? It hadn't gotten there yet. It's right here.
It's right here.
It's right here.
By the 15th.
Yeah, today they were lined up when I went after the extra calendars. You couldn't get into the bank hardly. There was no vacant chair. And I told all I wanted was calendar. She said, y'all doing Russian business? She said, no, it's dividend day.
Oh.
We should have gotten in ahead of that, shouldn't we?
Since it's the very last week, the board decided to put in savings. I'm sorry, we can't do that and let it collect the interest. And we don't really have to decide today. I mean, the money will be in safekeeping.
It won't be used from the district. It will not be used for the district.
Savings collecting interest and then we can spend it for the city. I think it belongs to the state. I don't see where it belongs to the district. Our district, you've worked hard for it, but we're for the state.
But they got their 40%.
See, they got their.
Yeah, they got their.
The state got their 40%.
This is our.
Get rid of belongs to the district.
We had a bunch of profiteers.
Committed that made it
intentional.
It really belongs to the district, but district.
What have we done in the past? I haven't made any money.
The state got.
We never made any before, to my knowledge.
They worked at it.
Well, it can't hurt anything being in savings if you
make a side lady.
Life
would take a little time to decide see how that. I'm ashamed of what's been out there. I paid out $10, and I doubt if I've paid mine. I don't remember. We have a very hard time getting each member to pay the $10, frankly. I think they would. They complain about the due right now. So maybe you always pick when you have more money. Tottering on the brink of complete financial disaster. There has to be a point of no return on the on membership dues when about 15 or 20% of the people who are working are supporting the organization. What we really need is membership. I know this is a real critical issue nationally as well as. Note from Hilda on the Christmas letter about this, and this is a real concern.
They had to cut their budget $1 million, and they said for survival for next year, and of course we too. 980 right now is a long cry from 1600. Oh, and the state the same way.
They've cut back a lot. cut out committee meetings and all that sort of thing. And I know that there's a tremendous concern about just sheer survival. And really, we cannot continue to go to meetings every other year and have the dues raised again and again and again, because each time it means a smaller percent of the working nurses are members. And there has to be some other way to do it. There are so many dissident groups these days who are being offered financing for varying setups. There's now a new coronary care group of nurses organizing, and then the operating room nurses and various splinter groups. And they are really not aware that they are being used by those other organizations that really, in a way, finance their activities. And this is what's going on, because I know that the operating room nurses have had a tremendous amount of financial underwriting by physicians and hospital and medical supply houses and that sort of thing, and I consider this unethical, really. I remember years and years ago when I was on the American Nurses Association staff, I had been tending the ANA booth at the APHA in St. Louis.
rode back partway on a plane in the seat next to Dr. Guy Rice, the old gentleman who used to be health officer in Georgia. And he had, at that time, I think he was president of the APHA, or he was incoming president or something, and he had become greatly concerned during the convention at the free flow of Curtis's, you know, with a capital C, only you spell it with a WH, and that sort of thing, at the public health convention. He's become greatly concerned about this because these people are taking tax write-offs and various things like this, you see, and he thought this was really inappropriate for health professionals to be accepting these kind of gratuities on a continuing basis, a 24-hour cocktail lounge basis, when these were the people whom you bought stuff from or selected your equipment and supplies from, and this sort of thing. And I remember Dr. Rice expressing a great deal of feeling about this. Well, this is what's going on with these dissident groups of nurses. I know because I was on the ANA staff when the operating room nurses were organized. And this raised a lot of glee on the part of certain groups. ANA Economic Security Program was just getting underway at that time. There was a lot of delight on the part of hospital administration and so on that they would have this group and the hospital and surgical supply houses, they could just extend all kinds of courtesies and help to this group. And I for one, was very disconcerted by this because I had to encounter it in my job as a PRO person for ANA. And I read a hospital administrator and a surgeon both right out of my office one day.
We had a small incident like that in Piedmont when we were trying to reactivate the general duty sections about 1962 or 63. And what they did, we had the meeting of the operating room here, and they gave them the nice big room and all of the facilities. And the general duty nurses met downstairs in the basement and had four or five members present, and whereas they had an almost an overflow upstairs. And it was on the same night, same time.
Well, I don't know if you all heard it state or not, but the hospital authority is organizing administrators in the hospital as long as the NSA section. They are organizing all over the state. I think in the 5th District, one of the few districts that they haven't officially organized in. In other districts in the state, they've already organized under
the Georgia Hospital Association. Probably too many people in the trade who are not professional, who don't understand what professional responsibility means. They just don't have any real professional.
And
speaking of
claims,
we can't
get
Well, there are two problems. One is an all-women group who find it very easy to be seduced by men's blandishments, really. And I was interested in something that happened. Turn that thing off for a minute. Not bothering much about that for the time being, and see what we can do to get as many people that are working back into membership.
I think the real crucial thing is the commitment of the young nurse. And I think it needs to be done very, very early to move. That's our only hope.
See, they don't
somehow or other, it has to be made possible for these young people to form this commitment very early, even before they finish school.
We had 24 new graduates out of approximately 500 who've got it for almost 2 years, and only four came back in this area. However, some of them went to other areas. We will make that statement on that. But 24 out of 500 at half rate.
They are following the example of the leadership. If the director of nursing has no commitment to a
professional organization. And I know nursing school faculties where there's hardly any membership. And if they have no commitment, then I don't know why we would expect the young ones to join.
We need
well,
to get them involved, too, it seems, so they're willing to get the feeling off the organization.
Well, again, I guess it goes back to how they measure what the membership brings to them. And I guess we have to really evaluate this and say, what does my membership buy me or does it get me? I mean, I think we know, but it has to make sense to the others.
Well, it's part of the, I consider membership a part of my working equipment. Part of my
that's why I'm saying I think if that commitment can start even before the nurse
yeah.
finishes school, I think if you can internalize this value, this belonging to profession. But then I think what happens is when you go in, as you were saying earlier, into whatever kind of a setting you go on in, whether it's education, whatever it is, then you internalize the values that belong to that particular system that you become
yeah.
a part of.
Well, I think it's going to take a while for us to get back and get a good public relations man because of the things that have happened for the last 2 years in Georgia and what the presses have done to the organization
mm-hmm.
by some of the propaganda that has been given out to the public. I think it's going to take a little while.
Well, I think you're right about that. Changes in the ANA headquarters office were 10 years overdue. 10 years overdue, we paid a terrible price for some poor decision.
I am just amazed at how many young students, and this is people who graduated, say, last June, don't know that the ANA is the official organization for nurses. Are not aware of this. And it's because they've never heard the words when they've been in school.
Well, they're being taught by young nurses who are not members, who have not practiced nursing, have no knowledge really about the roots and so on. A lot of them are, a lot of the faculty, and see, this is, a part of the consequence of putting all our eggs in the basket of education for training or for education and not giving the practice of nursing the same priority, you know, or the same status and prestige. See, we haven't put, until very recently, we haven't put the amount of quality emphasis on practice that we have on preparing to teach. And on teaching, and this has been made one of the problems for us. It was almost the opposite in public health. You see, they've derived their status and prestige from their practice.
No, it's different
now. You're beginning to get a few faculty members in, but there was a period when the schools of nursing had great difficulty getting faculty members because the public health nurses looked on their practices there. So all these are, you know, things we have to work with.
Well, I think even deeper than this, because speaking of public health, I have young staff members that I've given some of my administrative duties over to my assistant and been trying to really see through the young nurse's eyes, and I'm amazed.
I've got to disagree. There are 45 most eager, beautiful young people that are in the junior.
Now, nobody
so
says they were not eager and
they're
beautiful.
Committed.
Okay.
No, they're committed, and they're not only doing, wanting to do nursing, but over and above that, they're going out and doing things in social action.
Well, will they, those 45, join that professional organization?
Well, what I'm sitting here thinking, part of the, what we discussed, part of what it means to belong to a profession, but then we have to be able to say, what does belonging get me?
That's what they're saying.
Yeah, and what
when
does belonging get
them,
me? And I think
it is you. When you go in and you make it what you want, and we're not talking the same. Well, we're not talking about nursing.
I'm talking about nursing. I'm talking about commitment.
How students
do internalize these values, and the moment to internalize these values is so crucial.
Just in the last couple of days, the AMA has taken a position, come out with a statement on something. Now, not, you know, every young doctor sort of takes pride in the fact that the AMA is making pronouncements on the subject. Do you know that 2 years after the Joint Commission, this is an example of what we've been doing without I think what Rose and Merle are talking about. It was 2 years after the Joint Commission on Mental Illness and Health report was issued, which had more significance for nursing than any other professional group. If you read that report thoughtfully, it had more significance for the future of nursing in the field than almost any other group at all. It was 2 years before the ANA even had a meeting to discuss it after it was published. And even then, you could not get a position paper, a statement, or anything else out of it. You couldn't get ANA to even make a pronouncement on it. Well, even if your pronouncement is not popular or if it's wrong, at least you got a feeling that they're in there pitching. And I'm one of the ones that expressed outrage to the chairman of the group, the ANA, and made a lot of noise about it, tried to make noise in the right place. I'm not sure it did much good, but that's just a sample of what I think you two are talking about. These young kids are going to do their thing, whatever that is, and that's a phrase I don't like. But if it involves their professional organization backing them up in doing their thing or working with them or being in there on the thing aspect of it, then I think maybe they'll remember. It's kind of tough some of us old birds.
Don't talk the same language. We invite them in sometimes to meetings here. Well, they see middle-aged and up for people, you know, talking about what things we're talking about tonight, the reports from the lead committees, the financial things like that, and just interested at all. They like to see a lot of action or see some immediate results. And
part of the arrogance of ignorance, you know, there is a lot of the what I call the arrogance of ignorance displayed by these groups, but
to appreciate it, to internalize it, and it does take time and effort and planning.
Well, we will give them time, and then we lose the membership, and that's the one we can't get now. Then we say go back to the student group, and we can't get them. I'm partial too. I really am concerned about where we get members.
I would get them.
Well, I think what they see and what we say, there is a gap, is what they say. And I think this is the thing that is hard for them. counterparts whenever we have programs and ask them and get from them. They're very, very articulate and very, very verbal, but this is what they tell us.
So
what you say to us and what we read is not what we see.
We know that.
And,
yeah.
You know, and this is hard then for the credibility gap that exists in terms of believing.
And all this is what I'm talking about. So we don't, we're in two different worlds. And they can very well be involved until they join and are members and get invited to the, I mean, notice it all.
That's a
big,
it's a big
thing. And then give them a chance in and give them opportunity to be on committee and run for office and serve and see what can come up.
Let's face it, a lot of these kids have never listened to their parents. They've only talked to their parents. Their parents have listened to them. They haven't listened to you.
And we
they
want us to
listen, but
to take over them where that time.
They want us to listen, and a lot of times they could do a little listening too. I have a great deal of patience with a lot of it, but up to a certain point, I get, I guess I'm showing my age, but I think that this is the permitted generation, you know. And
well, they don't accept responsibility. They don't take anything, calling it tender national level and say, well, I can't invest it.
Yeah. Send it off, Caroline.
We invited them, and I have some new business.
Could I just say one thing, Joe? It seems that there is so much interest in this and such a real need that maybe we ought to be able to sit sometime and talk, make this a program in terms of talking about this as to what the young person thinks about the membership.
All over the young students, all over the area, Atlanta High School, wouldn't it be good?
Yeah, we could really get some kind of talking together about this.
Maybe we could develop something along this line for the May program meeting. Get them to put on the program and ask each group to.
Well, I think, again, if you give them all a responsibility, they need some guidance. But I was thinking some kind of mixture of really dealing with some of the things we're talking about right now and have some kind of an exchange like this with old and new. I just didn't want to, because it seemed like such a vital issue with all of us here, that it ought to be worth something.
What we can work out in the way of a...
Well, you know, I would also like to find out from the administrator, the hospital administrator point of view, because this I've heard over and over about staffing and how really inconsiderate young graduates are about their requests and their demands. I'm the director of nursing, and this I think Ms. Fitzpatrick said, you know, they call in at the last minute, and they're not even given a reason for why they're not going to be there. I know for a fact that Eggleston Hospital has suffered just grossly over the holidays because of this, and it's not the auxiliary staff, it's the professional nursing staff that is doing this.
Most of the auxiliary staff has to work for a living and
live
there.
And I think this is, you know, might be a real good topic to pursue and have some real good exchange.
The old and the new.
We'll see what we do with it. See if we get it and take us.
I'd like to recommend, when you get to that point,
yeah,
I'd like to recommend a couple of people.
Any other old business?
Get average people. Don't get the outstanding. Because, you know, it's the average man we're after.
Well, I'm talking about people who know how to express themselves and really say what's on their mind and what they're looking for.
Oh, we'll collect a sample of them. What we can do.
Any other old business? I had a very nice letter from Honeycutt in the private duty section, and she has a request for us that she would like us to consider. Would it be possible for the 5th District office to make available bill heads with the 5th District seal on each page showing the nurse is a member of the GSNA so that she can present a professional type bill to her patients? Many of us are proud of our organization. We want people to know we are members in good standing. It's very embarrassing to see nurses present the kinds of bills I've seen presented. It's so unprofessional. The practical nurses do better than this. And Ms. Honeycutt and her group have worked very hard to get members of private duty section.
Is she asking that for those that are members?
Right, are only members in good standing.
Having to resort to any old type of statement they can pick up, whether from the hospital or whether they have their own maid or nothing with a professional status could be presented.
And will we be able to cover it for the qualified
member? Well, if it came into the district, no one except the member would receive it if it was so sent from the district office. Or if you wanted to, after they're printed, let them, Ms. Honeycup or someone like that, have charge of it and selling them. Or a committee, as a chairman of a committee. But I think coming from the office would be better.
This board is responsible for headquarters, and headquarters would have to be responsible.
Well, that, I'd be willing to do it, because I feel like, as a former private duty nurse, that I would be I certainly would not join the registry, which was against my professional organization, and I certainly would not want one that Abby rents give, because it's just advertising. And I would very definitely feel that I would, as long as I had paid my dues, that I would be entitled to some recognition. So I think it would be a very
I was really very, very pleased with this action that came from this group. I think they've really done something in a very nice way.
179, you still have that many members.
Yeah.
That's right.
Was the motion?
Yeah, I move that we honor this request.
Please, Ms. Crawford.
Does this have to be brought up before the membership?
It
would be in the
resume when she announces it Thursday.
She includes it in her motion that it would come through headquarters, not just honoring this request, but that headquarters would do it, so that the legal part of it.
Distributed through headquarters, available to members only, or something like that?
Headquarters be responsible for a distribution of bill heads.
To members only, or something like that. Mm-hmm.
To members in good standing. Let's make sure.
Yeah.
We may have somebody you want.
Well, they wouldn't be a member if they were not.
They won't go through headquarters.
It would be better that way. Of course, it would be easier for the girls out, like Ms. Honeycutt and some of them who are in contact with them, but it wouldn't be, I personally feel that it might encourage some membership thing.
Mm-hmm.
It cost us some money, but we're going to have to invest in it anyhow.
How much would it be?
I don't know. I have to get an estimate.
we've had them done through another lithograph people used to.
Who seconded the motion?
I said I should know this was the next place.
Did you tell me what time?
All in favor?
I think that's.
Opposed?
Ms. Kate's on.
Is there any other new business?
We're good, I was trying to get.
I have some announcements.
Announcements you can do.
Announcements I can do without Ms. Slot. We're all set. On April 20, 21, 22, and 23, there is a nurses, a program for registered nurses, which will be held during the Southeastern Surgical Congress at the Marriott Motor Hotel here in Atlanta. The registration fee is $10 per the entire meeting, and this has to do with surgical nursing. April 20th, 21st, 22nd, and 23rd. Ms. Pope is presiding at one afternoon. Ms. Woody's presiding Tuesday morning. Ms. Callahan is presiding Tuesday afternoon, and let's see.
Rosecrans is presiding one time. She's down at the bottom now.
Oh, yes. Marilyn Rosecrans is presiding Monday afternoon. But I have the program here if any of you are interested in just looking over the topics. I need this back, though. It sounds like it's going to be a real interesting meeting. Planned Parenthood Association is having a luncheon meeting January 21st from 12:30 to 2:30. The speaker is Mr. James Finch, who will discuss Atlanta in the year 2000, and he's a local architect. Preceding the annual meeting of this Planned Parenthood Association will be a panel on birth control in Atlanta, which will be from 9:30 to 11:30 that morning. And doesn't say how much the tickets are, does it?
It's probably on the reservation card.
Please reserve one space for the meeting. There's no price.
Okay. Well,
maybe
I don't
it's
know.
Free.
It just came in this morning.
Oh, the only thing that they charge you for luncheon tickets, which are $3.50. Parking's free.
What's the name of that? Oh, I'm sorry. Let me.
There was another one. I had one more announcement. Oh, that's what it was. Does anyone else have any other information, announcements to share with the board?
We've got the folders for the ANA convention. Just got it this morning. You'll be hearing about that later. Anybody wants to see it, won't take 1 second to show it to you. Wait a minute. About Miami, so forth, and get ready to go. And the man from the Delta Airlines, they might be interested in this, is planning, and we'll contact the state on making up a plane. Now, it won't be a chartered plane by any means, but anyhow, with the group that they could get the fine services, whereas if they went the other way, it'd be on one of those special Oily birds, isn't it?
Yeah.
Instead of oily ones. But anyhow, he is going to work some program out, and there'll be some announcements about that, but we'll order our posters for the convention. And they were going to send out some income tax deduction for nurses, but they said they were going to hold on to that until the new information is out.
There'll
get
be
that
a lot of nurses at that meeting. I wonder how many will be at the district meeting Thursday.
Oh, is that the same day?
No.
No.
Oh. Not the same day. That's in April. But it'll be interesting. It, you know, I think
it's in Miami.
because I'm not going to raise my dues anymore to support the, an organization that is so little, such as very small, set of the, I'm going to oppose any raising my dues.
I guess we're really all caught up in.
Those of us who are members are caught up terribly these days in this contest of a power struggle. It's a real power struggle. But there'll be hundreds of nurses at that. They'll be easily, see, it's from all over the Southeast. There'll be easily 700 nurses attending there.
And when you think about, you know, the ANA was so disappointed in the attendance of the clinical sessions here. I think it'll be real interesting to sit back and see what happens with that. Are there?
Yes, it will. I want to be sure the census is taken.
Are there any other